This is the Ed Schultz Show, where America comes to talk.
Here we go, dictating exactly what the terms are going to be to raise the debt limit. For more on that, let's bring in my friend Mike Papantonio, host of the Ring of Fire radio show. Mike, great to have you.
How are you? You know,
we're good, buddy.
Just another way. You know, Republicans can't govern without descending into this something that looks like corn pone, trashy New Jersey Shore type drama. And so now you have Boehner out there leading the charge. I mean, it's just typical. And you know, when you look at what he's saying, Ed, I mean, I think this guy is really capable of saying, yeah, we're going to close things down. We're going to fire our uniformed personnel that's still serving in Iraq, serving in Afghanistan. We're not going to pay them. And we're going to Homeland Security, we're going to close down 250,000 workers, no pay, no border patrol, no airport security, no U.S. Coast Guard. We're going to close down the CDC and the National Institute of Health. We're going to allow financial regulations to go virtually unregulated, unchecked. This is the kind of stuff that they're talking about. And he really, honestly, he is capable of that kind of craziness. And you know what? I think it inures a benefit to progressives to let these guys, give them enough rope. We've all seen it before. You know, give some cat enough rope and he's going to hang himself. I say push it, let it go.
I see that House Speaker Boehner last night in New York, delivering a major speech on the deficit at the Economic Club of New York and rubbing elbows with the Koch brothers.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, one thing he didn't mention, though, I got to tell you this, Ed, he didn't mention that Bush raised the debt ceiling 7 times. He didn't mention that it's not a spending problem, it's a revenue problem, that Mr. Koch there was part of the people that benefits from the $60 billion lost every year by corporations not paying taxes, or the $100 billion that's lost every year because, you know, we give them their offshore banking. It is $12 trillion. Yeah, this is a staggering number, but let's take the bottom range. The bottom range I've heard on it is $7 trillion. The top range is $12 trillion in untaxed assets that are hidden all over the globe by people. I'm not saying the Kochs do it, but people just like the Kochs do it. It's hidden out there. We're losing $160 billion a year. That's what he didn't talk about. He didn't mention a word about that. But I tell you what he does want to cut. He wants to cut Medicare. He wants to cut Medicaid. He wants to cut Social Security, health care, NPR, Planned Parenthood, EPA, FEMA, Head Start, food stamps, you name it. He wants to cut all that. But he doesn't want to have a billionaire pay more taxes.
Boehner and Koch appear to have a friendly relationship, according to Think Progress, as Koch met with Boehner's staff in the Speaker's office on the first day of the new Congress, where Koch was hosting a party for freshman GOP lawmakers, trying to find out, I guess you could say, who they could potentially have a relationship with.
Right. It's worse than that, Ed. I know you follow this story from time to time. You'll hear, did the Kochs actually write the consensus paper? Did the Kochs actually have their people write the white paper, the talking points that the Republicans are standing up in front of a camera and delivering? Did they actually write it? And, you know, time and time again, that issue comes up. We all know Boehner is not the sharpest tool in the shed. He's not the kind of guy that comes up with his talking points. For example, we're hearing the argument now. This is coming out of Boehner's mouth, and we're hearing they're all saying this. Their argument is that if they could, for example, privatize Medicare, that it's going to give future recipients the kind of option that congressmen have, that they're going to get the same kind of money. But when the Congressional Budget Office looked at that, they said it's ridiculous, it's nonsense. At most, government would pay about 30% of all of this that people have to make up the other 70%, while they pay Congress about 80%. But Boehner doesn't think about that, Ed. Boehner doesn't come out and say, this is my idea. You have to have a guy, you have to have an organization like Koch that has these think tanks behind them, and the think tanks write the talking points, and then they deliver to a guy like Boehner, and he parrots it like a, you know, like a brainless parrot.
What should be the Democratic strategy working against Boehner now that he's fighting on the debt ceiling? I mean, obviously, we're going to have to raise it.
Yeah.
And if we don't, it's going to hurt a lot of people. And this, they're going to try to make this the soft underbelly of the Democrats and paint them as the tax and the spenders and whatnot. The fact of the matter is the country's going to have to function through the next cycle. So what should the strategy be for the Democrats?
I'm seeing Kent Conrad do it out of North Dakota. Ed. He is educating the public. He's talking about the things like, hey, you know, I don't get this whole thing. Bush raised the debt ceiling 7 times. Republicans went along with every single time. What's different about this? Kent Conrad's out there saying, look, you want to draw your line in the sand? We're going to draw our line in the sand. No tax increases. They're going to have to be there with spending cuts to have a credible plan to solve the problem. Every now and then you'll have a Kent Conrad that'll rise up from the ranks and kind of pull the sword out of the stone and say, this is what we're going to do. I hope they'll continue talking tough. You had Boehner that had to admit that he was asked, are these draconian cuts? He said, yeah, they're draconian cuts. Is this irresponsible to even think about closing down the government? Boehner said, yes, it is. So the more the public hears a guy like Kent Conrad talking about why it's important that we not do this, talking about how the world financial market looks at us like we're a bunch of chumps, they lose more confidence in America as a superpower. Yeah. Kent Conrad's out there saying the thing, and all he's doing really, Ed, is educating the American public. The American public is not stupid. Once they hear the facts, they do respond.
Well, on the other hand, now Conrad, who is the chairman of the Senate Budget Committee, is also part of this gang of six.
Yeah, that's true.
Now, whereas Conrad wants to raise the debt ceiling, he is also going after major changes in Medicare, Medicaid, and Social Security.
You're right, but at least you got. He's a blue dog Democrat. He's the guy that, from time to time, you know, we're always critical of. I've been critical of Kent Conrad time and time again. But if rather than the blue dog Democrats caving in and saying, yeah, we're going to give the Republicans everything they want, I love to hear a guy like Kent Conrad saying, no, spending cuts are going to be tied into tax increases, and that's the only way we're going to go forward with it. Don't get me wrong. I'm not, you know, on most issues, Kent Conrad is on the other side of the universe. But you're going to have 6 or 7 blue dog Democrats. They've got to show some backbone, and they have to say what's clear. You can't have one without the other.
I really wish that the Democrats would say everything's on the table except the big three: Medicare, Medicaid, and Social Security. that's the way they're going to have. Yeah. They can't negotiate away programs that have been successful for the American people, especially when 80% of the American people don't want any changes,
right,
and 72% want to see the rich pay more. I mean, the Democrats can't get any better numbers on their side than what they have right now.
I know, Ed. That's the point. That's the point. They have all the public opinion on their side. Once the public hears, now let me get this right. You want to cut Social Security, and you want to privatize Medicare. You don't want somebody besides government running all this. Once they understand what's at risk, once they understand that if they're 55 today, by the time they're 70, that the government's only going to pay about 25% of all their medical costs, and they have to figure out how to get along without it. Once they hear that, then all of a sudden they start saying, yeah, well, it's important that we cut this deficit. But when it starts affecting them, it kind of hits closer to home. And that's what Democrats have to do, especially the blue dog Democrats, who for so long have abandoned the progressive movement. And that's why, look, if Kent Conrad's out there saying encouraging things, let's let him do it. Let's let him bring those 6 boneheads that usually don't vote Democrat, don't vote for progressive. Let's let them move the discussion.
Mike Papantonio, host of the Ring of Fire radio show here on the Ed Schultz radio show. Great to have him with us always.